I don't want to live in a world where Kiss is not available performing live. And right. I don't care. They've even said, listen, you know, Gene and Paul don't have to be in the band. I've heard Paul say this. Like, they can just trade up, market out, and they might have other dudes in makeup and go out there and do this. And I will always have a place in my heart for Kiss because they were a band that always gave bands, their up-and-coming bands, a shot. Our first real arena gig was opening up for Kiss in 1995 at the Key Arena in Seattle. And we had nothing. Our first record came out. It didn't even sell 10,000 copies. But they were giving every band their, like, their dream come true in case it didn't happen. They
really?
Did it. Oh, they did it.
Out of the goodness of their heart? Because I know, again, interviewed Jesse Malin from
D-Generation. They did like 2 years with them, like Kiss did.
But I'm not sure he ever met them.
Well, he might not. Well, it's funny enough, we met them coming down the stairs. They were there in their makeup, and they took a picture with us. So they were just nothing but gracious with us. It was one show. And I said, if my whole rock and roll career and music career is one show opening for Kiss in Seattle, I'm fine. You know, going back to the whole, you know, why do bands still do it and stuff? You don't ask a dentist who's like 52, hey, dude, you still doing that dental thing? You know what I mean? It's what we do. Once you become a certain age and you have a certain success, and if the people still want it, we're still going to do it, man.
There's no exit strategy.
But why, though? It's right. Something you love doing. You got the golden ticket. You're in Willy Wonka's factory. Why would you take your uniform off and go, I'm going to quit playing? And I know it's not for everybody. That's why some of the original members leave, guys, because they can't hack it anymore or they don't love it anymore.
Yeah.
You have to love it the long way. I love performing. And I've joked before, like, I'll be in a Denny's in Barstow at 75 doing my third set of Sugar Ray songs, and I'll die with my mic in my hand singing Fly with my face into a Grand Slam breakfast. And that's the way I want to go out.
And
please don't feel sorry for me. I love performing. It's what I do. It's in my blood. So sometimes people are like, why can't you the original guys get back together? And I always say, if you can call your original boyfriend or girlfriend tonight and go out to dinner with them and have a great time and do whatever you used to do, let me know, and I'll get the original band back together.